Good morning, Bellevue Heights, and welcome to this week's edition of BHC Prayse. I was thinking about prayer this week, and I read somewhere that to pray is an admission of dependence. You see, a self-assured person is not going to pray prayers of petition. Why, there is no need to pray if you think you've got it all covered and all under control. A self-righteous person is not going to pray prayers of confession. There is no need to pray if you think you're perfect and there is no sin or wrongdoings in your life. But the person who knows how much they need God and how much they need God's help to make it through the day, how much they need God's forgiveness to move forward, that is the person who understands the importance and the purpose of prayer. The Apostle Paul was such a man. In worldly standards, he achieved great success, probably the greatest missionary the world has ever known. Yet he was totally and completely dependent on God. He knew without God, nothing was possible. But with God, all things were possible. Of all the things he accomplished, he gave all credit and glory to God. I love the hymn writer Arthur Anger, who described it in this poem. It said this: "All we can do is nothing worth unless God blesses the deed. Vainly we hope for the harvest tide till God gives life to the seed." Friends, this undergirds all of Paul's thinking. One plants the seed, another waters the seed, but only God can make it grow. I want to share with you these thoughts as we join together in prayer today. As you go and look at this prayer list, I encourage you to intercede to God, to realize that God is sovereign, that God is in control, and we are desperately in need of God. We are not self-assured. We need God. We are not self-righteous. We must confess our sins to God. So let's begin by confessing and repenting and then interceding to God on behalf of these prayer requests. Join me now as we pray. Thank you for joining us for this week's edition of BHC Prayse. I hope and believe that you had a meaningful time of prayer. And I want to thank you for caring for others, to be concerned, to take their prayers, to take their needs, to take their hurts and their troubles and their sicknesses and go to God on their behalf, believing that God is able to hear all things. God is able to do all things. Therefore, we take the concerns that we have and lay them at the foot of the cross and give them over to God, the one who can do all things. Encourage you, and may God bless you today. Amen.